Welcome, and thank you for joining the Industry Insider webinar, AI and the Future of the Staffing Industry. I'm Amanda Javro, SVP, Chief Credit Officer at Tricom. As an administrative and financial solutions provider to the staffing and consulting industry, it is our philosophy to be an active member of the staffing industry by staying abreast of the ever-changing marketplace. For that reason, Tricom was pleased to launch the Industry Insider webinar series designed to share our expert knowledge and resources with our fellow staffing industry colleagues. One of our core values is to build relationships and become a leading resource to staffing and consulting firms nationwide. Our presenters today are Brad Smith, Chief Strategy Officer, Haley Marketing, and Jeff Gibson, CEO of Haley Marketing's sister company, Recruiters Website. Today we are listening in on this conversation as Brad and Jeff explore the impact of AI in the staffing industry and how it can be leveraged as both a threat and an opportunity. They discuss the importance of embracing AI to future-proof jobs and businesses in the industry and provide examples of AI tools that can be used in business development, recruiting, and marketing. The conversation emphasizes the need for recruiters to combine AI automation with human outreach to enhance their effectiveness. Live examples of AI tools are demonstrated to showcase their potential in streamlining processes and improving efficiency. The conversation covers various topics related to candidate marketing, resume tailoring, finding more candidates, and to use the use of TalentScribe for content creation. This Industry Insider session is broken out into three episodes and explore each of these themes in detail, providing insights and examples of how to leverage AI tools for recruitment and marketing purposes. So let's listen in.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thanks so much for joining this Lunch with Haley. Today, we're going to be talking about AI, artificial intelligence, and how it's impacting the staffing industry. So why will AI really impact the industry? Our clients are going to expect it. At Haley Marketing Group, we're already seeing that. Clients are expecting, especially on the marketing side, that you're using AI to be more effective, more efficient, and be more productive. So do more with less. It's going to rule because it's going to help us make better data-driven decisions. We are so great at collecting data, we're not too great at analyzing it and using it. AI is going to help us do that. So that might be data in your CRM, might be data in your ATS, might be data on other platforms that you use. Let's begin using all that data that you've been collecting over the years, and let's use it to make better decisions. It's going to improve recruiting performance with speed, hopefully diversity, hopefully our quality of hiring. So how are we going to use it? Well, for business development, we're going to find prospects. We're going to improve our outreach, both our quality and quantity of outreach. We're going to automate repetitive and administrative tasks. It can help us improve sales training. You can use the AI to do role-playing, and even role-playing for a specific type of company that you're going after and targeting. We'll figure out what questions to ask, what objections, how to answer those objections, how to move past those objections. We can use it for sales forecasting, our lead scoring. We can use it for lead generation. We're seeing chatbots be very effective at helping move people through the funnel, through the sales pipeline much more quickly, qualifying them and providing a better experience. It can help with lead qualification. So let's look and dig a little bit deeper and look at examples of AI for business development. One thing that I hear from staffing companies all the time is, you know, we don't know exactly who to target in our organization. We don't know who the buyers are. We don't know within those organizations who to target, who to focus on. So here are some list building tools that we've looked at. There's Apollo, Seamless, Sales Mirror. Great opportunity for us to use these tools to build stronger lists and then do automated outreach. There's note-taking tools like Fireflies, Read AI, Notion. Zoom released some free AI capabilities. I will tell you, whenever I'm having a client call, discovery call, sales call, consulting call, I'm using these note-taking tools. And from there, I'm taking a transcript, and then I'm turning that transcript into a follow-up email for our clients, into a list of action items for our internal team to act on. into training tools so that I can take that one high level conversation consulting call that I had with a client and share that with some of our newest team members so that they can see the types of questions I ask and the responses that our clients are getting so that we can better lead the industry. You can do the same thing with your internal team. It can help dramatically in training and onboarding and also provide a better client relationship. Jeff, you were going to say something?
Sorry, Brad. Even on interviews. So if you had a Zoom interview with a client and candidate, you're able to take notes, provide a summary back to the client, and then gain some insight as to what kind of questions are being asked.
Yeah. In this industry, speed is everything, isn't it, Jeff?
Absolutely.
Yeah. So use these tools to make it more effective to get this to the rest of your team, to follow up with a client immediately, to move things forward. There's a bunch of automation platforms that I bet most people on this call are have access to, but maybe aren't using to their fullest. Let's start using them to eliminate all the inefficiencies in our organization. We can use it for email writing, and I think a lot of people are. Go ahead, Jeff.
Sorry, Brad. We did get a question. Do you want to take that now or wait?
Yeah, let's take it. What is it?
Carlos wants to know, is there a legal framework that allows AI to decide about who passes pre-screening and get the opportunity to have an interview? And what about bias?
Yeah, so let's leave that question to the end so our legal expert is on. I'm kidding. We don't have a legal expert joining us. But there are real questions around that. So AI is inherently biased because of the data that's available. And I'll share a quick example. AI is helping with dermatology and skin cancer detection. Okay, so most of the US population doesn't have the ability to go see a dermatologist, and there's a shortage of dermatologists. And AI is helping there, and AI is being used to detect skin cancer. For white people, it is, I believe the number was like 92% effective, but for those of darker skin, it's only 72% effective because of limited data sets. So I share that, and it's obviously different than hiring, but we have to understand that there is potentially some inherent bias with the use of AI, especially on the hiring and interviewing side. So I don't have a solid answer for you right now. I don't think that I think we're still learning and still determining and evaluating where the bias comes into play, but we have to be aware of that. We have to, again, pair AI with the human to make better decisions, but I wouldn't rely on AI specifically. But Carlos, I don't want to sidestep your question. Really, I think it does make sense to talk to legal counsel a little bit to figure out where that line exists. But I think it's going to be a moving line because as we continue to see, there's more and newer AI all the time, and the large language models are still learning and collecting data and updating consistently. So it's something that is going to be a little bit of a moving target.
And I just had a little bit to add to that. And I think that you hit the nail on the head with the personal attention, you know, the being there as an individual, as a recruiter, your expertise is greater than just relying on a bot essentially to make a hiring or firing decision. Or hire or not decision, rather. Just like when I was recruiting, we had certain companies that would hire strictly or not hire strictly based on assessment. And we're like, well, you haven't actually talked to this person. He's, you know, he or she's great. We get past this assessment stuff and actually get down to talking with him and working with him and finding out if they're a fit or not. And that's where, you know, being a recruiter, we can kind of step in and say, this doesn't make any sense. Whatever the bot says, if they're using something, if your client's using something, we have to push back a little bit. But I, as a recruiting and staffing firm, I would use AI to automate the everyday tasks, but leave decision-making to the human, at least for now.
Couldn't agree with you more. And using AI and the data available will help you be able to get to that human decision quicker.
Right, exactly.
All right, so to wrap this slide up, a few other ways to use AI for business development. We're going to use content tools like a copy AI, like ChatGPT, like Jasper, like TalentScribe, which we'll get into. There's great tools for LinkedIn like Evy AI or Outboundly that can help you market at scale. Chatbots are an amazing way to move a prospect down the funnel, help them get the information they need quicker, faster, more effectively. It improves the customer experience. And then video outreach tools like Tavis or BeHuman that allows you to do video outreach at scale that's personalized to the end recipient. So how will AI be used in recruiting? Well, it's going to help you improve your employer brand, accelerate sourcing, create better job titles, profiles, evaluate resumes quicker, do quicker and faster skill assessments. But as Jeff just pointed out, we don't want to just solely rely on it for skill assessments. We need to improve the interview process to make it easier and better and more efficient and effective for the candidate. Reference checking can be a great asset for us and help us speed that process up. And then finalizing the presentation of candidates. So think about how much time it actually takes you to present a candidate. We can streamline that. And some specific examples or tools for AI and recruiting. For job profiles, ChatGPT, TalentScribe can be used. For interview questions, Interview AI, Dover, DeepBrain. Some of these will actually do the pre-screening interviews for you to, again, speed up that process and make it more convenient for the candidate so that they can do some of these on their own asynchronously, and you can speed up that whole recruiting process and interviewing process. Candidate screening like Fast Track, video interviewing like Interview AI or BeHuman, at the application with auto applies and streamlining that. Now, finally, I want to address how AI will be used in marketing, in helping you get your brand, your name, your company, your people in front of more potential buyers and in front of more candidates. Can help dramatically with employer branding and positioning you as an expert. It's going to dramatically accelerate content creation. And I think based on our chat at the beginning of today, a lot of people are using it already. It's going to improve scalability. It's going to help us reach more people faster. Can enhance personalization. There's a ton of studies out there that say in order to really stand out in the market, you need to personalize your brand, your approach, your marketing efforts. The tools now are amazing to help you reach a big, reach people at scale, but personalize it. That BeHuman tool that I've mentioned a few times will actually let you record a video message, but personalize it based on a database and have a person's name right there. And it will be an AI-generated name, but it will match your voice, your tone. And it's a video. And it almost looks seamless. It's awesome. Some examples of AI for marketing. Obviously, some of the blogging tools, some of the content creation tools. There's design tools like Midjourney, Adobe Firefly. I just saw in ChatGPT's one of their recent releases, DALL-E is integrated. Canva just released a ton of amazing tools that will help you. Microsoft Copilot is embedding it in all of their tools. The Adobe Suite is amazing with generative fill and other ways. We're streamlining everything. Social media, we're using tools called video.ai. We're using tools to help turn what would have been a task that may have taken 20 hours into a task that maybe takes 2. It's absolutely amazing. With video, there's Pictory, there's Lumen 5, there's BeHuman, Animoto, voiceovers. We can get professional voiceovers done by AI extremely quickly. 11 Labs is a great example of that. LinkedIn, a tool called Evy AI, I mentioned earlier. So there are great tools out there right now to help with marketing, to do it at scale, get your brand in front of even more people. Now, getting back to Dr. John Sullivan, a noted expert in the recruiting and HR space. He thinks and predicts that the key to every recruiter's job security is going to be learning everything that they possibly can about AI. And I love this chart. This is not one that we created, but I think it is a great indicator of what you can do to evolve as a recruiter, evolve as a staffing or recruiting organization, and combine AI, automation, and human outreach. So everything that you see above that recruiter line, these are human tasks, or maybe even evolved human tasks. Okay, these are things that probably doesn't make too much sense using AI to help with at this point. But everything below that, and you can see some of these: screening, your assessments, scheduling, profiling, job matching, parsing. These were historically human tasks that a recruiter is doing. Okay, we can transfer all of these in purple over to an AI today. And really get your recruiters to a point where they can begin building those personal relationships more frequently. At Staffing World, one thing that I heard over and over and over from staffing company owners and from recruiters themselves is that they spend the majority of their day on data entry or data cleanup. How crazy is that? Okay, that can all be eliminated, so that they can get to what makes them more money, what helps drive commissions for them, what helps drive gross margin for you, and streamline things. And then everything in orange down here, these are new tasks that could be completed with AI, like lead scoring, job insights, engagement scoring, referral scoring. Okay, these are things that can help drive more value in your organization, both for your bottom line and drive value for clients. So the question I always get is, holy cow, Brad, holy cow, Jeff, there are so many tools out there. Where the heck do I start? What do I do? Where do we go? And I'm going to reiterate it for a third time. Don't feel like you have to do everything immediately. Pick something that makes the most sense for your organization and do it. And I suggest starting with mapping out your processes. Go through the process of screening. Go through the process of recruiting a candidate. Go through the process of sourcing. Go through the process of candidate outreach. And list out on a whiteboard, on a sheet of paper, all of the steps that you take. And then look and see what can be automated through AI and do it. It's going to free up so much time for your recruiters to get down to that personal connection. Look for those repetitive actions. Look for the headaches. Identify the things that you hate doing. Ask your team what they hate doing. You know, what task shows up on their desk every week, every day, every month that they just dread? There's probably an AI that can eliminate that. Ask yourself as an owner or a C-level executive, what do you hate doing all the time? Can you stop it? Is there an AI for that? Test writing tools like ChatGPT, Jasper, Talent Scribe. It's going to help you improve job profiles, sales emails, outreach. It's going to help your salespeople to do role playing and improve when they're actually speaking directly with a prospect. Test image creation and video creation tools to make marketing and selling more effective. Test tools that make you more effective, like Read AI or Zoom AI, after your meetings. Okay? It can be a great note taker, and it can give you an actionable list of things that you need to do immediately after that call to follow up with the client, follow up with the prospect, follow up with the candidate, and drive more value. And then evaluate tools that you can use to directly engage with clients, with talent, chatbots, sourcing AI, screening AI. For our own Haley Marketing Group career portal, we're looking at integrating AI to make it easier for candidates to match, make it easier to determine what candidate applications best fit that job application. Okay? A lot of those updates are coming. So that's just a few things that you can do.
We have a couple questions.
Go.
You just answered one of them about will AI be incorporated into Haley Marketing's career portal, which is underway. And then the other question here is, let's see, I've been on the job seeker side and have not particularly enjoyed it when a company sends me a recorded response to interview questions as the first part of their screening. As someone in recruitment, I don't deny that it's efficient, but as a job seeker, it has felt very impersonal. Is there any data to show how candidates respond to these types of tools?
I don't have any data off the top of my head, Jeff. I'm not sure if you do or not, but I will tell you that you need to look at it from both sides of things. And I think the person brings up a good point in that we need to not only look at it from a cost savings or time savings for ourselves, but what's in it for the end recipient. If we're using AI and we're making the lives of the candidate harder, it's not going to save us time in the long run. It's not going to drive revenue in the long run. Right. On the flip side, if we can personalize it or maybe approach the candidate with a why, or maybe outline what's in it for them, then I think it could work. So instead of just sending them automated follow-up after they apply that walks them through what the next steps are, maybe explain to them that, hey, the reason that we're doing this follow-up is to make sure that we don't waste your time. It's not about us. It's about your time. We want to make sure that when we have that conversation, when we take the next step, we have really thought things through and we're not going to waste your time. So that's why you want to fill out these few questions. So that's the way I would approach it. And I would think of it from both sides to make sure that you're making the right decision for your clients, your candidates, and your business.
That makes sense to me. Couple more. Let's see. What would be the best tool to explore if I am a job advertiser and my biggest issue is helping my recruiting team work through candidates in a timely manner? So I think this is referring to job applications. So getting tons of job applications, how can we screen them quickly?
I would look, I would actually have a more in-depth conversation with your staffing software provider, with your ATS. Almost every ATS now is incorporating and embedding AI tools within that. Right now, we in the Haley Marketing Group Career Portal have something called Resume Match or Talent Match, which helps on the candidate side to see and allows them to look at their resume to determine if they're a good fit for that position. So that's one way to help. But I would have deeper conversations with your ATS and ask them specifically what tools they're incorporating or already have available to help you do that. There are a lot of others out on the market. Jeff, do you have anything that you'd recommend?
No, I really don't. I mean, I would probably look at I like to combine automation with AI, and I would look at building out something specifically for this if it was my company.
Excellent. All right. And whoever asked that question afterwards, if you do want to submit that and reach out, we'll have an email address at the end. We can have our team follow up and share some tips, best practices, and other tools that you should consider and take a look at.
Thanks for listening in to this episode of the Tricom Industry Insider webinar on AI and the future of the staffing industry. We'll see you in our next episode.